Good afternoon, everybody. My sincere thanks to Shweta for giving us this opportunity to address this SMEs forum. And I welcome on behalf of Profectus Capital, everyone, each and everybody who is present here to be part of this journey. And let me just have a very small presentation. So initially we thought of giving a little bit of information about the company. Then we thought ki it's a basically SME forum, so why not to talk much about you rather than us. So Profectus Capital, it's an NBFC. We have already completed 5 years of journey and we are into SME lending. And I'll just be talking about our company in the little bit later stage. But let us begin the presentation. It's a small presentation, not much. This is the changing circumstances. So if we want to divide it in the three, four categories. So it will be the digitization of our economy, which will be Aadhaar, DBT, direct to the, the transfer, UPI, that we know. Demonetization and GST is one of the factors. And then the globalization, there is the quality, cost, environment, and labor will play. And we also know about the COVID-19 as well as the Black Swan events. So it is the changing circumstances which each and everybody is facing, and we are also being the similar kind of fraternity, and with the SME since last 5 years, we also been seeing this particular things happening with each and every SME on a very, regular basis. So if we want to categorize that, so these are the four basic categorizations where there is a digitization of our economy, demonetization and GST, globalizations and COVID-19 and other effects which have already happened in recently. So basically the question is, what does it mean to us? So scale is important, definitely this is for each and every SME. Vision of making it big, definitely long-term focus, R&D and innovations, which has to be there in each and every SME segment, and fundraising ability. So these are the four basic things that we normally expect, or rather we see that each and every SME should be having. And one of the most important factors is the governance of the SME, where your tax compliance, labor laws, environment, and transparency during the good and bad times will definitely play a key role. And prepare for uncertainty, right? So next slide, please. So leveraging the ecosystems. So what are the things that we need to do or should be doing? One is the liquidity buffer, ready and at call support, liquid investments. So this is one of our normal advice to each and every SME, just to have a liquid investment, what the earlier speaker has also told about a right balance of debt and equity, as well as short-term investment kind of things, where there will be a liquidity where you'll be able to raise it. Everybody has seen what COVID has done to most of the businesses and how liquidity has played a role over a period of time. So ready and at call support, liquid investments, stay away from real estate. This is one of the advices that we normally give, and we have also seen during our experiences, this is from the experience, we see that it's a real or easy money people think, and most of the funds are being diverted to the real estate. So the situation is not like that what used to be there in the 10-15 years time, where the overnight investment in equity or real estate is giving a lot of money. So it's a little bit dangerous side, so stay away from the real estate. And managing working capital well. So this is some of the liquidity buffer that one should keep. And apart from that, some of the supports that from the government side that we have already seen over a period of time. One is definitely ECLGS, where that has also been extended for the hospitality sector at presently. We have seen the sub-debt scheme, where the restructuring has been done to many a companies who have been, under stress for the liquidity as well as the repayment, and during the COVID time they have suffered a big business setback. And there are subsidies we everybody know that what kind of subsidies company or the government has given. So Parijibhai, if I'm talking about that trades and other things also and subsidies, there are 450 schemes which have been introduced by government, where 90 million people have been benefited, where 8.2 lakhs crore have been disbursed over a period of time. So apart from that, banks and NBFCs definitely choosing the right partner. So banks will definitely be, the approach will be a little bit on a stricter side, but NBFCs will be a little bit more aggressive and flexible. So that is up to you that how you will be balancing your debt, whether to take it from the NBFCs and banks, and what kind of balances you are going to make in your entire portfolio, that kind of decisions that one is to take. And trades and other platform, this is the trade receivables, or what we call the bill discounting kind of things, which is also one of the government's initiative. And there is GeM, which is the government e-commerce market, where it has been basically created for the larger and bigger corporates to face their products and services from the market. So what do financial partners look for? Basically being a, being a financial partner like Profectus, what basically we'll be looking for from a SME is the vision, skill and domain knowledge, definitely, that whether a particular SME will be having a clear-cut vision, required skill and the domain knowledge. Skin in the game, whether he has also invested, subsequent or sufficient kind of his equity into that particular business or not, and whether there is skin in the game or not. Openness and transparency, that we normally discuss whenever we see, we try to find out whether the client is very open and there is a transparency in the business or not. And preparedness, definitely, everybody has now learnt a session or lesson during this particular COVID time, whether to be prepared for all the bad times and how to deal with that. Governance, it is one of the most important things. There is nothing called easy things, though the government is helping a lot to the all the SMEs, but it is up to them to have a very solid governance system which should be built in their company. And now the government is very strict, and you never know when things will be, or you will be scrutinized for each and everything. So governance wise, there has to be total compliance, and willingness to take everyone along. This is also one of the factors, which is one of the things that we also see. And thinking big, definitely. Now scale is the game. So now it is up to a balance whether you want to make it a highly profitable business by not scaling up, or whether you want to scale up and maintain your profit low, what kind of balances you are going to have in your company. That is a bigger decision to take, and it's a kind of balancing figure that each and every SME is to take over a period of time. And now comes the company, Profectus Capital. This is your partner in progress, unique cluster-based approach. One of the companies, or one of the NBFCs, who is basically into the clusters. So we are a company who is basically into the clusters. So we only fund some of the targeted clusters which we think which are having the prosperity in the business, and the government is also supporting that. And we have seen in our past experience how those businesses are doing well in the marketplace. So it's a cluster-based approach where we want to specialize over a period of time to help you grow in that particular business. Team, a pioneer in MSME lending. Definitely it has already been 5 years in this journey. Basically the company has been formed to facilitate and help the SMEs to grow in their business. Strong equity backing, Actis, a UK fund. So our the equity partner is Actis. Actis, one of the leading equity-based company from the UK, who is having some of the associations in India like Axis Bank and IDFC and National Stock Exchange. So Actis is the backbone behind Profectus Capital. Values-led growth, I try values create value. What we normally, this is our DNA of the company, where it is more towards the innovation, transparency, empathy, and some of the innovations or some of the DNAs that we drive for our company during the journey. And we also ensure that each and every employee of the company believes in this, the DNAs of the company. Presence across the country, we're already present across 22 branches. And we also cater to so many spoke locations, so it's a hub and spoke model. So all together we are covering Pan India. Aim to cross 3,500 crore books by March 2023. We are already a 1,500 crore company with A- rating, stable rating. And we are actually trying to cross 3,500 crore by this end of this year and approximately 10,000 crore by 2025. And flexible offerings for your varied needs, being a NBFC company, apart from offering the mortgage loan, what we normally call enterprise mortgage loan, we also offer equipment loan and school funding, as well as supply chain finance, bill discounting products. So this is from our side, and this is Profectus Capital, and NBFC for the SME lending platform. Thank you.